Hello, dear brothers and sisters who want really to know the truth. Today we're going to talk about the Trinity. As we see in the picture, that it says that the Father is not the Son, and the Son is not the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is not the Father. So it looks like three different persons, but one God. So when we read the Bible, I have read the Bible, the whole Bible, and I never saw that the Holy Spirit to pray to the Father, or the Father to pray to the Holy Spirit, or the Holy Spirit to pray to the Son, or the Son to pray to the Holy Spirit. So we can see there is a chaosm here in this picture, which means it's impossible to be these three persons as one God, because it's contradicting the each other. For example, you cannot find never in the Bible something like the Father will ask from the Son, or the Father will ask from the Holy Spirit, or the Holy Spirit will ask from the Son, or the Holy Spirit will ask from the Father. Which means this is something that three different persons that cannot be one person. So it's clear that this is not one God, but three gods. Actually, these three persons came from the, I mean, this one person, the Father, came from the Jewish religion. The Son and the Holy Spirit came from the European paganism. So the Jews, they make from their own religion another game, another paganism. So when we read what is the Jewish God, is it he the real God? So when I read the Genesis chapter 18 verse 81, it says that God is speaking here like, I will go down now and see whatever they have done altogether according to the outcry against it that has came to me, and if not, I will know. So which means this is very clear that this God is not the real God. He needs to learn here, to hear, to see, to learn the situation, what's going on. Which means clear this is not the true God. And also we read in this Trinity, these three people, these three persons, as one that they say, he cannot be God, because here he's lying here, he sent lies. Like for example, in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 11 it says, and for this chaos, for this reason, God shall send them a strong delusion that they should believe in a lie. Which means here he is sending a lie. So first, in this picture, it's clear that here there is not one God, but three different persons and three gods. But are these real three gods? No. This, the Holy Spirit, came from the Egyptians' religions, which came from different spirits. The spirits, they were clear, the Satans who went in the human form or in dove form. And this Son came also the same from the European paganism, like Hercules, like this kind of paganism. And this Father came from the Jewish paganism, which you all saw, like he needs here to learn, to see how is going on in the world, what happened in the world, means he's not all-knowing. Also, when we read in the Bible that we cannot find nowhere Jesus to be the like all-knowing, all-powerful, all the Holy Spirit or the Father. All this was clear, shows that this Trinity cannot be all-powerful. He needs to learn everything, or to see what's going on, or somebody to tell him. It's clear. And this was also proof that this God is clear, not the God, but somebody like Satan or something like that. So as my solution for you guys, if you want to learn the truth, there's only one truth. As an ex-Christian, I learned and I found the truth. You go here, islamreligion.com, and you read about the truth that is real truth. So when you go in this website, you can check the articles about the God, about what is Islam, or the similarity between God, between Christianity and Islam. Which is clear that the Quran, I mean the Islam, has clear proof for God. He has a lot of scientific proofs. And so if you go in this website, islamguy.com, there are some evidences of the truth that Islam is the only truth, like the human embryo, or the Quran mountains, or Quran origin of universe. And you can click here and you can see that the Quran is 1400 years ago and tells incredible miracles about today. Which means clear, and in Islam, God is very clear, he is all-knowing, he doesn't need to learn or to hear, he knows everything, and he is one, there is no trinity or this kind of paganism. So he never lies, so he doesn't never give this kind of games. So if you need to learn the truth, my brothers and sisters, go to the islamguy.com or islamreligion.com, you can learn it through. It's up all to you, but if you wanna go in paradise, there's only one way. As I search, as an ex-Christian, I become a Muslim. I'm a Greek Muslim right now. So this